wet your hands with water. Apply soap, rub your hands palm to palm, and wash the backs of both hands and in between your fingers. Then palm to palm with fingers interlocked. Clasp your hands together and rub, and then clean around the thumbs too. Rub your fingertips in the palms of your hands and finish off with the wrists. Rinse your hands really well with water and dry them thoroughly with a paper towel. Use the towel to turn off the tap. Your hands are now clean.
Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamu alaikum. This lecture is presented to you by Pakistan International School, Riyadh, for the subject of Islamiyat Grade 1, and I am your teacher, Ms. Aruba Agha. Okay, so the contents of our today's lecture are: aim, we will discuss our today's objective, that what we are going to study today. Summary, then we will discuss the summary of our whole lecture, and at last I will tell you the homework and what we will be studying in our upcoming lecture. And in the last class, we started unit 15, that was the stories from the Quran. We read page number 55, that was all about two friends. Okay, so we read half of the story, and today we will be continuing story of two friends. Let's see what happened next. So before that, let's have a review of the story we learned in the last class. Okay, so starting with first paragraph, just hold your pencils in your hand and underline the difficult words or the hard words, or also the words which you are listening for the first time, and then I will explain you the meaning of those words. Okay, so let's start. His friend said, "Have you forgotten Allah? He is the one who made you. I believe that there is only one Allah. He is my Lord and Master. Why did you not remember him when you entered your garden? Why didn't you say Mashallah?" Then he added, "As for riches and family, Allah might bless me with a lot more soon and may take away from you what you have." So in this, we have learned that Allah is one. So the friend said, "Have you forgotten Allah? Ki kya tum Allah ko bhool gaye ho? He is the one who made you. Wohi hai jisne tumhe banaya hai. I believe that there is only one Allah. He is my Lord and Master." Aur wo dost kehta usse ki main is baat pe yakeen rakhta hu ki Allah wahid hai aur wo mera malik hai, mera khalik hai. "Why did you not remember him when you entered your garden?" aur wo apne dost se sawal poochta hai ki tumne Allah ko kyun nahi yaad rakha jab tum is baagh ke andar dakhil hue. "Why didn't you say mashallah?" tumne mashallah kyun nahi kaha. Then he added, "As for riches and family, Allah might bless me with a lot more soon and may take away from you what you have." और उसने अपने दोस्त से कहा कि अगर तुम्हें अपने अमीर होने पे या बड़ी फैमिली होने पे गुरूर है तो हो सकता है कि अल्लाह मुझे कल को और अता करे और तुमसे ये सब भी ले ले जो तुम्हारे पास है. Why? Because he forgotten Allah. Okay, so starting with the second paragraph, it says this is exactly what happened. Allah does not like such proud people. Soon, the proud man's garden was completely destroyed. His fruit trees fell over and he was left to cry over his misfortune. So in this, you have to underline two words: destroyed. This word is destroyed. Iska matlab hota hai tabao barbad, tabao jana, barbad ho jana. And this word is misfortune. That means badkismati, theek hai? So kya hua ki jaisa uske dost ne kaha tha, bilkul waise hi hua. Why? Because Allah does not like such proud people. और क्या हुआ, जिसको अपने बाग पर नाज था कि उसके पास इतना खूबसूरत, इतना प्यारा बाग है, गार्डन है, वो क्या हो गया, बिल्कुल तबाह बर्बाद हो गया. His fruit trees fell over and he was left to cry over his misfortune. उसके जितने भी ट्रीज थे जो फ्रूट्स थे वो सब गिर गए, ख़राब हो गए और वो अपनी बदकिस्मती पे रोना शुरू हो गया. व्हाई ऑल दैट हैपेंड? बिकॉज ही वॉज फीलिंग प्राउड कि उसके पास इतना अच्छा बाग है, इतना अच्छा गार्डन है और वो दूसरे पर्सन से कह रहा था कि मेरे पास इतनी बड़ी फैमिली है, मैं इतना अमीर हूँ. सो ही वॉज फीलिंग प्राइड ओवर दैट थिंग. सो अल्लाह टुक ऑल दोज थिंग्स बिकॉज ये कौन हमें देता है, ये सारी चीज़ें हमें अल्लाह ही अता करता है, ये हमारी अपनी तो नहीं होती. सो अल्लाह कैन टेक वेन एवर ही वॉन्ट. सो वी मस्ट ऑलवेज थैंक अल्लाह एंड वी मस्ट नेवर बी फीलिंग प्राउड ऑन दीज थिंग्स बिकॉज अल्लाह डज नॉट लाइक प्राउड पीपल. Now let's see the third paragraph and it says Allah has given us everything. He can take away His gifts just as He has given them to us and no one can help us. We must always thank Allah for what He has given us and never be proud. ठीक है, तो ये सारी चीज़ें हमें किसने दी होती हैं? अल्लाह ने ही दी. इतनी अच्छी दुनिया दी, इतने अच्छे हमें फल दिया है, फ्रूट्स दिए हैं, वेजिटेबल्स दिए हैं, फूड दिया है, ये सारी हमारे लिए अल्लाह की तरफ से क्या हैं? ये गिफ्ट्स हैं. ठीक है, और वो जब चाहे हमें दे सकता है, जब चाहे हमसे वापस ले सकता है और कोई कुछ भी नहीं कर सकेगा. सो वी मस्ट ऑलवेज थैंक अल्लाह फॉर वॉट ही हैज़ गिवन अस एंड नेवर बी प्राउड. हमें हमेशा अल्लाह का थैंकफुल रहना चाहिए, हमें हमेशा शुक्र करना चाहिए कि अल्लाह का शुक्र है कि उसने हमें इतने सारे गिफ्ट्स दिए हैं, इतनी सारी चीज़ें दी हैं, और उन पर कभी भी गुरूर नहीं करना चाहिए कि अल्लाह ने तो हमें ये दिया, तुम्हें तो कुछ भी नहीं दिया. सो दैट्स द बैड थिंग, दैट इज़ द प्राउडनेस एंड अल्लाह डज नॉट लाइक प्राउड पीपल. सो वी मस्ट ऑलवेज से शुक्र अल्हम्दुलिल्लाह फॉर एवरीथिंग. ओके, सो गिव थैंक्स टू अल्लाह फॉर एवरीथिंग. So now, as we have read the story of two friends, now we are going to do exercise number 2, that's on page number 58 of your book, in which we have given a word bank already, and there are 4 statements in which we have to choose the words accordingly. So let me read out the first one, in which there is Allah is our Lord and dash. Allah is our Lord and dash. So we all know that Allah is our Lord and Master. Allah is our Lord and Master. So what you will write in this blank, you will write Master. Okay, so here you can see the word Master. You will write Allah is our Lord and Master. Now let's see the B one. The proud man was dash and had a bigger family. The proud man was dash and had a bigger family. He was richer. So you will write the word richer. The proud man was richer and had a bigger family. Okay, now let's see the C one. He dashed to say mashallah when he entered his garden. He forgot to say mashallah when he entered his garden. Okay, so whenever you see a beautiful things around or you feel blessed, always say mashallah. ठीक है, जब भी आपको कोई चीज़ अच्छी लगे या कोई चीज़ पसंद आए या आपको अल्लाह का शुक्र करना हो, सो ऑलवेज से माशाल्लाह. लेकिन जो प्राउड मैन था वो माशाल्लाह कहना भूल गया, बल्कि उसने उस पर गुरूर किया. सो अल्लाह ने उससे वो सारी चीज़ें छीन ली. सो ही फॉरगॉट टू से माशाल्लाह व्हेन ही एंटर्ड हिज गार्डन. ओके, नाउ लेट्स सी द डी वन. अल्लाह गिव्स अस एवरीथिंग. ही कैन टेक अवे हिज डैश इफ ही वॉन्ट्स टू. सो we will be writing the word gifts. So you will write the word gifts. Allah gives us everything. Allah हमें हर चीज़ देता है and He can take away His gifts if He wants to. और Allah चाहे तो वो हमसे वापस ले भी सकता है. So we must always thank Allah for all the things He have given to us. Okay? He Allah gives us everything. He can take away His gifts if He wants to. So you have to do this exercise number 2 on your book and it is on page number 58 of your book. Okay, my dear lovely students, so today we will be doing unit 15, two friends, and today we will be doing question number C, that the short answer, and you have to do that in your Islamiyat copies, and we will also be doing question number D and E of exercise 1. These two are the detailed questions, okay? So these two are also supposed to be done on your Islamiyat copies. So let's start with question number C. Before moving on, let's have a look on the objectives that what you will be learning through this unit. You will learn that Allah is the only one who gave us everything. Okay, so He is the master, He is the Lord, and He is the only one who gave us everything. Okay, He can take away from all of us if we do not thank Allah for the gifts He have given to us. Allah does not like proud people. Yes, Allah does not like proud people. Those people who think that all those things are only blessed or given to them, so they feel proud. And that Allah does not like those people who show pride. We must thank Allah for all the gifts. Okay, so like food is a gift for us, this planet Earth is a gift for us, and all the blessings around us is just a gift of Allah. So we must thank Allah for all the gifts He have given to us. Allah can take all the blessings from the people who show pride. Why? Because Allah does not like proud people. So He can take away all the blessings if we do not thank Allah and we show pride. So we must always thank Allah and always say MashaAllah whenever we see a good thing. Okay, so starting with exercise 1's question number C, that's on page number 57 of your book. Let's see what's the question. So this is the short answer, and let me read out the question first. Who had given him all that he had? So here we are talking about those two friends who were blessed with a beautiful garden. So who gave him? We all know that Allah had given him all that he had. So who had given him all that he had? Allah had given him all that he had. Okay, so Allah is the only one who blessed that proud man with a beautiful garden. Okay, so you will be writing this question first, in which the question is who had given him all that he had, and you will be writing answer then Allah had given him all that he had. Allah had given him all that he had, because Allah is the one who can give us everything. Okay, so in the same way that proud man was blessed with a beautiful garden, and who gave him that? Allah. Okay, Allah had given him all that he had. So you have to write this short answer in your Islamiyat copies. Now let's move on to the question number D of exercise 1. That is also on the page number 57. And this is the detailed answer. So what's the question? Let me read it out first. What did he forgot to say when he entered the garden? What did he forgot to say when he entered the garden? So here we are talking about that proud person who forgot to say MashaAllah. Okay, he forgot to say MashaAllah. So in this you have to write this question first, in which you will be writing what did he forgot to say when he entered the garden. He forgot to say MashaAllah. Okay, so MashaAllah is a phrase which we use to praise Allah's blessings. Okay, we used to say to thank Allah. We used to say whenever we see a good thing or a beautiful gifts of Allah. So always say MashaAllah when you see something very beautiful or you are blessed with a beautiful gift. So first of all, just write this question. What did he forgot to say when he entered the garden? And then you will write the answer. He forgot to say MashaAllah. Okay, he forgot to say MashaAllah. So this is the detailed answer, and you have to write in your Islamiyat copies. Okay, so now moving on to the next part, that's part E of exercise 1. This is also a detailed answer, and it is also on the page number 57 of your book. So let me read it out. What's the question? It is, what happened to the proud man's garden? what happened to the proud man's garden. So here we have to tell that what happened to proud man's garden when he forgot to say mashallah and he didn't thank Allah. So what happened to his garden? His garden was destroyed and all his trees fell over. Okay, his garden was destroyed and all his trees fell over. Why? Because he did not thank Allah for the blessing he have, and he forgot to say mashallah as well. So you will be writing this question first, which is what happened to the proud man's garden, and then you will write the answer. His garden was destroyed and all his trees fell over. That was the punishment for him because he showed a pride. Okay, and Allah does not like proud people. So in this way he got his punishment, that his garden was destroyed and all his trees fell over. Okay, so you have to write this question and answer in your Islamiyat copy. Okay, so now it's your homework time. What is your homework? That you have to write and learn exercise 1's question C, D and E on your Islamiyat copy. Okay, so you just have to write and learn exercise 1's question C, D and E on your copy, which we have done in the class. And in our upcoming lecture, we will be doing exercise 1's question A and B. Both these questions are oral discussion. Okay, so we will be having discussion on them orally, and we will also be doing the last worksheet, worksheet number 3. Okay, so I have already shared worksheet number 3, so you can make a printout and keep it ready for your next class. Much for listening to me in this lecture. Hopefully you have learned so much about Islam, and in our upcoming lectures you will learning some more things that are good for your knowledge and that are very important for you as a Muslim to follow those instructions which are good for you. See you in the next class. Take care. Allah Hafiz. Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamu alaikum. How are you all, my dear lovely students? I hope you all are fit and fine and safe at your homes. This lecture is presented to you by Pakistan International School, Riyadh, for the subject of Saudi History, Grade 1, and I am your teacher, Miss Aruba Agha. So we will be focusing on our today's aim, then I will tell you your home assignment, and then I will tell you what we will be learning in our upcoming lecture. So discussing the new things that we are going to cover today, let's have a recap on the things we have learned in the last lecture. Okay, so let's have a review on the things we did in the last lecture. We learned question number 11, that was all about fill in the blanks, and the statement was, if we want to say thank you, we would say dash. So in this blank we have to write an Arabic word for thank you. So we learned that shukran is an Arabic word for thank you. So if we want to say thank you, we would say shukran. Shukran is an Arabic word for thank you. Now let's focus on today's aim. So we will be learning some new question, and hopefully you all are ready to learn the new one. So today we are going to continue filling the blanks, and today we are going to do the second statement. So let's see what's the second statement, and it is dash is the capital of the Saudi Arabia. So in this we have to write the name of a city that is the capital of the Saudi Arabia. So in this picture you can see that it's written Riyadh, and we all know that Riyadh is the capital of the Saudi Arabia. So what we will write in this blank, we will write Riyadh. Riyadh is the capital of the Saudi Arabia? So the second statement was dash is the capital of the Saudi Arabia. So Riyadh. Riyadh is the answer, and you will write in the blank, Riyadh is the capital of the Saudi Arabia. Okay, so your homework is just to learn question number 11, second statement, which was dash is the capital city of Saudi Arabia. So Riyadh is the capital city of Saudi Arabia. So this is your homework, you just have to learn it. Okay, thank you so much for listening to me in this lecture. See you in the next class with some more new things. Take care. Allah Hafiz. Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. Assalamu alaikum. How are you all? My dear students, I hope you all are fine and safe at your homes. So, let's start our computers lecture. This lecture is presented to you by Pakistan International School, Riyadh, for the subject of computer science for grade 1, and I am your teacher, Ms. Aruba Agha. So the contents for our today's lectures are: recap, today's aim, homework, and I will tell you about our upcoming lecture. So before starting our today's lecture, let's have a recap on the things we did in the last lecture. So we started a new practical work regarding the calculator. So I introduced you how to use the calculator, and we did a practical activity in which we did addition and subtraction sums using calculator. Okay, so in question number 1, let me read it out. It's all about Mr. Laptop. Find and write likes and dislikes of Mr. Laptop. Okay, so here are given you some 5 statements, and here are 2 options for you. So you have to find from these options, and then you have to write in these blanks. Okay, so let me read out the first statement. What it is? It is Mr. Laptop likes to stay dash. Mr. Laptop likes to stay dash. Your options are unclean or clean. So we have learned that Mr. Laptop likes to stay clean. So it's C, it's already written, and AN is also written. So what letters are missing? L and E. So you will write these 2 letters in these blanks, like L. Okay, so first of all, you have to circle the word, and then you have to write in the blank. Okay, so L E, that makes clean. C L E A N, that makes clean. So Mr. Laptop likes to stay clean. Okay, so in this way you have to attempt this question number 1, in which you have to choose from these options. You have to circle the correct one, and then you have to write the missing letters. Okay, keep Mr. Laptop dash. Keep Mr. Laptop dash. Your options are safe, unsafe, safe, unsafe. So we all know that Mr. Laptop likes to stay safe. So we will circle the word safe, and you can see that F and A is already written, but S and A are missing. So we will write S and A. That makes S-A-F-E, safe. Keep Mr. Laptop safe. Okay, moving on to the third one. Mr. Laptop hates dash. Okay, so here D is written and S is written. Let's see the options first. Your options are dust, desk, dust, desk. So Mr. Laptop hates dust. Dust is the correct one. So let's see which letters are missing. So here we can see that D is already written and S is also written. So U and T are missing. So we will write U and T. That makes dust. Mr. Laptop hates dust. Okay, so Mr. Laptop hates dust. Now let's see the fourth one. Hold Mr. Laptop dashly. Hold Mr. Laptop dash. So your options are roughly and gently. Roughly, gently. So the correct option is gently, and E and S are missing. So we will write E and N here, that makes gently. Hold Mr. Laptop gently. Let's look at the last one. Keep Mr. Laptop dash. Keep Mr. Laptop dash, and your options are dry, wet. Dry, wet. So we have to keep Mr. Laptop dry. So we will write D-R-Y. That makes dry. Keep Mr. Laptop dry. So this was the question number one. Now let's see the question number two. And in question number two, that's a very easiest one, in which you have to color the clean and properly placed computer or a laptop. Okay, so in this picture you can see that it's properly placed and it's clean. And in the second picture you can see that there's some water spills, and that's a broken one also. There's a laptop that's broken, its monitor is totally broken. So which one is the clean and properly placed computer or a laptop? This one. So you have to color it. Okay, I am not going to color it. I am just going to make a square box to indicate that this one is the clean and properly placed computer. Okay, but at the home you all have to color it neatly. Okay, so this was our question number two. Let's see the question number three. Okay, in question number three, you have to match with the correct description. At the right hand side, you can see there are some pictures given to you, and at the left side, there are some descriptions. So I will be reading out the description first, and then we will be matching it accordingly with the pictures. Okay, so do not eat while using the computer. Do not eat while using the computer. So in this picture, you can see that this boy and this girl, they both are eating while using their computer. So that's not allowed. So we will be matching this. Do not eat while using the computer. So make a straight line using your rulers. Do not eat while using the computer, because they both are eating. Keep your workspace clean. Okay, so keep your workspace clean, because computer and Mr. Laptop hates dust and they like to stay clean. So this is the clean space. You can see that it's placed properly and it's also clean. So we will match keep your workspace clean with this picture. And let's see the third one. It says always turn off the computer when not in use. Always turn off the computer when not in use. So in this picture, you can see that on screen, this girl is going to shut down, and we can see that it's written shut down. So we will be using our rulers to make a straight line, and we will match always turn off the computer when not in use with this picture. Do not bang on the computer. Do not bang on the computer. Here you can see that this boy is banging keyboard on the monitor. So that's totally not acceptable. That's the wrong thing. Okay, that can damage laptop or a computer. So we will be matching this line with this picture, in which we have to tell him that boy, do not bang on the computer. Okay, do not bang on the computer. Handle carefully the laptop. Okay, so in this picture you can see that this boy is handling the computer very carefully by putting both his hands under the laptop. So that's the correct way to hold your laptop. So we will matching handle carefully the laptop with this picture. So we have done with the question number three, in which we have to match these pictures with the correct description. Okay. Okay, so in question number four, we have to write N for the wrong statements. N indicates no, and Y is for yes, that is to be written for the right or correct statement. So let's start with the number one. It says keep your computer clean using dry cloth. Keep your computer clean using dry cloth. So Mr. Laptop hates dust and it loves to stay clean. So we will be writing yes, because this statement is right. We have to keep our computer clean using dry cloth. Now let's see the second one. It says eat and drink while you are using computer. Oh, this is wrong. So we will write N because Mr. Laptop hates food and drink. So we will write N. Now the third one is play with magnets near computer. Okay, that's also no because Mr. Laptop doesn't like magnets and we have to keep magnets away from the computer. So we will be writing N. Turn off your computer when not in use. So that's true. That's correct. So we will write yes. And we will writing Y. Do not hit the keys on the keyboard. Do not hit the keys on the keyboard. So that's also the correct statement because if hitting the keys on the keyboard hardly or harshly, it can broke our keyboard. So that's right. So we will write Y. That's the correct one. Okay, so that was our question number 4. Let's see the question number 5 now. So in question number 5, we have to join the dots and fill in the color. That's very interesting and very colorful activity. Okay, so what you have to do, you can see that there's written A, B, C, D. And you can have an idea that there's a mouse, there's a keyboard, and there's a monitor. So what you have to do, you have to join the dots like A and B. We all know that what comes after A, it comes B. So we will match A with the B and then B with the C and C with the D. And D with the E and E with the F and then F with the G, G with the H and so on. So in this way, you have to complete the dots. You have to join them all together and then you have to fill in the color. So now after joining, we can see that this is the monitor, this is a keyboard and this is a mouse that makes a happy desktop. So this is an exercise number, question number 5, and you have to do it at your home. So today's aim is to revise unit 5, keyboard layout. Okay, so today we will be discussing layout of a keyboard. I know you already are familiar with that, but today's aim is just to learn more about keyboard. And the objectives are, we will be learning that what is keyboard. There are some special keys like spacebar, enter key, backspace, shift, control. There are numeric keys by which you can type numbers. There are alphabet keys as well by which you can type your name, your city, and so many more things. So let's see about keys and the keyboard. So we all know that keyboard is a input device which helps us to insert data inside the computer. So let's discuss the layout of the keyboard. So in this, you can see that these are function keys. Each is written with F, so that means function 1, function 2, function 3, function 4, and so on up to the function 12. Okay. So these are the special keys in a way that they have some special functions designed. Like this is for printing, this is for break, this is for insert, this means page up, page down, delete and end. But in our keyboard we have some more special keys like backspace key, which helps us to erase the mistakes, enter key, which helps us to insert data inside the computer, and this is a space bar, which helps us to put space between two words. These are the direction keys or navigation keys, which helps us to move up and down, left and right. Okay, so you can see that these arrows indicate the directions. Okay, and these are the numeric keys in which we have numbers written on them. Okay, so this is also numeric keys and this is also numeric keys. Okay, so these are the lock keys. Num lock means you have locked the numeric keypad. Caps lock makes your letters into capital ones, and scroll lock means you can easily use direction keys by locking this word. Okay, so this is the normal keyboard of our laptop or computer. How to place properly your hands on keyboard. So this is very important, that how you can place properly your hands on keyboard. By following the correct technique or methodology, You can easily type anything you want very fastly and effectively without committing any mistake. So here you can see that we have divided keyboard into two parts, left hand keys and right hand keys. Okay, so you have to put your left hand on the left hand side and you have to put your right hand on the right hand keys. So you have to start with your pinky finger of your left hand, putting it on A and then S, D, F. Okay, your index finger should be on F and your thumb should be on space bar. And again, for the right hand side, you have to put your index finger on J and then your middle finger on K and then L, and this is apostrophe. And then you have to put your thumb on the space bar. This is the way that how you can put your hands properly on keyboard, both the hands. Okay, so these are the left hand keys in left hand and these are the right hand keys with your right hand. So J, K, L and this comma and A, S, D, F. So this is the way that how you can properly place your hands on keyboard. Now let's talk about some special keys. So as we have learned already earlier in our classes, that backspace, enter, shift, alt, control and backspace key, these all are the special keys. But for now we are just learning about backspace key, which helps us to erase the mistakes, works as eraser. Sometimes typing fastly we can write something wrong, so for that we can use our backspace key, which helps us to erase the mistakes. Enter key enters the data into the computer, so enter key is also a special key which helps us to insert the data into the computer. Whenever you are typing on the word pad or Microsoft Word, while pressing enter key makes you to the second line. Okay, so that moves the cursor into the second line. And spacebar is the special key which helps us to create spaces between two words. For example, you can see that I have created spaces between, so you can see that this is the space and this is inserted by the spacebar. Okay, so these three are the special keys for now, but later on in your higher grades you will learn more about the special keys. Okay, so for today we are doing an activity in which you have to fill in the missing keys on the keyboard. So here you can see that there is a layout of a keyboard in which there are some number keys and some letter keys, but letter keys are missing. So you can take a help from your computer or laptop's keyboard and then you can fill in the missing keys accordingly. So let's start from here. So there we can see that it's written W. So we all know that in our normal keyboards there is Q. So we will be writing letter Q. Okay, and after R in normal keyboards we have T. So we will be writing letter T. Okay, and here it will be P. So now we have completed the first row. Moving on to the second one. Here A, S, D. So we will be writing D, F, G, H, J, K. Okay, so now we have completed the middle row also. Moving on to the third one, in which we have a character or a letter Z, and then we will be having X, C, V, B, N, M. So in this way we have completed an activity. I have already shared the PDF version of these keyboards. You can take a print out and then you can do it accordingly. And in your homework you have to complete the keyboard missing letters. This is the homework one. We have already done with that one in the class, and this will be your homework, that in which only just the first row is filled and other second two rows are missing keys. So you have to fill in the missing keys accordingly by taking help from your laptop or your computer's keyboard. And what we learned today, let's conclude our lecture now. we learned that the keyboard is used to enter letters and numbers. The keyboard has letters, numbers, and special keys. The enter key helps us to enter data. The backspace key helps us erase data. The space bar inserts a space between two words. So this is the summary of our today's lecture. Now let's see what we will be learning in our upcoming lecture. So in our upcoming lecture, we will be doing another activity in which we have to find the words and color the keys. Okay. Thank you so much for listening to me in this lecture. I hope you all have enjoyed today's activity and you have learned so much more about the keyboard. See you in the next lecture with new more things.
اعوذ باللہ من الشیطان الرجیم بسم اللہ الرحمن الرحیم شروع اللہ کے بابرکت نام سے جو بڑا مہربان اور نہایت رحم کرنے والا ہے۔ السلام علیکم پیارے بچوں، آپ سب کیسے ہیں؟ میں امید کرتی ہوں کہ آپ سب خیریت سے ہوں گے، اور اللہ تعالیٰ سے دعا ہے کہ اللہ تعالیٰ آپ کو صحت و تندرستی کے ساتھ اپنی حفظ و امان میں رکھے، آمین۔ اور میں آپ کی عربی کی ٹیچر مسز نجمہ نرگس آپ کو ایک بار پھر عربی کے اس نئے لیکچر میں خوش آمدید کہتی ہوں۔ جی تو پیارے پیارے بچوں، آج ہم نے اپنی عربی کی بکلیٹ میں پیج نمبر 25 پر کام کرنا ہے، ٹھیک ہے؟ تو سب بچے جلدی سے اپنی عربی کی بکلیٹ نکال لیں اور پیج نمبر 25 نکال لیں تاکہ ہم اپنا آج کا کام شروع کریں، ٹھیک ہے؟ جی تو سب بچوں نے پیج نمبر 25 نکال لیا ہے۔ اچھا بچوں، جیسا کہ پہلے بھی آپ کو پچھلے لیکچر میں بھی بتایا تھا کہ اب ہم اپنی عربی کی بکلیٹ میں سارا کام کر چکے ہیں، یعنی تمام حروف تہجی لکھ چکے ہیں یا تک، ٹھیک ہے؟ اب ہم وہ کام کر رہے ہیں جو ہم پہلے کر چکے ہیں، یعنی ریویژن کر رہے ہیں، ٹھیک ہے نا؟ تو آج ہم نے کیا کرنا ہے، آج ہم نے جسم کے حصوں کے نام لکھنے ہیں، ٹھیک ہے؟ یہاں پر تین تصاویر دی گئی ہیں، یہ ہمارے جسم کے حصے ہیں، تو آپ نے بتانا ہے کہ ان کو عربی میں کیا کہتے ہیں، ٹھیک ہے؟ آپ کو یقیناً یاد ہوگا، آپ یہ کام کر چکے ہیں، لیکن اگر نہیں بھی یاد تو آج آپ دوبارہ سے یاد کر لیں تاکہ آپ کو یاد رہے، ٹھیک ہے نا؟ چلیں، اور کچھ بچوں کو تو یاد بھی ہوگا، تو چلیں کام شروع کرتے ہیں اور دیکھتے ہیں کہ سب سے پہلی تصویر ہے کس کی؟ منہ کی، ٹھیک ہے؟ اور منہ کو عربی میں کیا کہتے ہیں، کسی کو یاد ہے؟ ویری گڈ، منہ کو عربی میں کہتے ہیں فم۔ کیا کہتے ہیں؟ فم، فا اور میم، فم۔ فم کا مطلب ہے منہ، ٹھیک ہے؟ کیا مطلب ہے فم کا؟ منہ، ٹھیک ہے؟ اچھا اب یہ دوسری تصویر تو ناک کی ہے نا، ہے نا؟ تو ناک کو عربی میں کیا کہتے ہیں، کون بتائے گا؟ پتہ ہے آپ سب کو، تو پھر بتائیے جلدی سے کیا کہتے ہیں ناک کو عربی میں۔ ویری گڈ، انف۔ کیا کہتے ہیں؟ انف، ٹھیک ہے؟ انف ناک، ٹھیک ہے؟ انف ناک۔ اچھا اور اب تیسری تصویر تو آنکھ کی ہے نا، آنکھ ہے نا؟ تو آنکھ کو ہم عربی میں کیا کہتے ہیں؟ یہ بھی بہت آسان ہے، سب کو پتا ہوگا جی، کیا کہتے ہیں؟ شاباش، عین۔ عربی میں آنکھ کو کہتے ہیں عین۔ کیا کہتے ہیں؟ عین، ٹھیک ہے؟ تو یہ ہمارے تین جسم کے حصوں کے نام تھے جو ہم نے لکھے، اور کیا کیا تھے؟ فم، منہ، انف، ناک، عین، آنکھ، ٹھیک ہے؟ پھر سے ایک دفعہ پڑھیے میرے ساتھ، فم، منہ، انف، ناک، عین، آنکھ، ٹھیک ہے؟ یقیناً سب کو یاد بھی ہو گئے ہوں گے نا، ساتھ ساتھ یاد ہو گئے ہیں؟ ہاں جی، فم، منہ، انف، ناک اور عین، آنکھ، ٹھیک ہے؟ اب آپ نے اس کو بھولنا نہیں ہے، ٹھیک ہے نا؟ اب یاد رکھنا ہے تاکہ ایگزام میں بھی آپ سے اگر پوچھا جائے تو آپ کو پتا ہو، ٹھیک ہے نا بچوں؟ چلیں جی بچوں، تو اب ہم نے کیا کام کرنا ہے، اب ہم نے صحیح عدد پر دائرہ لگانا ہے، ٹھیک ہے؟ یہ آپ نے دیکھے نا تین باکس ہیں، ان میں مختلف تصاویر ہیں، تو آپ نے ہر باکس میں جو تصاویر ہے ان کو آپ کاؤنٹ کریں گے اور اس کے بعد دیکھیں گے کہ یہ کتنی تصاویر ہیں، تو جو صحیح نمبر ہوگا اس کے گرد ہم دائرہ لگا دیں گے، ٹھیک ہے؟ تو سب سے پہلے والے باکس میں کاؤنٹ کرتے ہیں، یہ کتنی تصاویر ہیں؟ واحد، اسناب۔ کتنی ہیں؟ واحد، اسناب، ٹھیک ہے؟ تو ہم اسنان کے گرد دائرہ لگائیں گے، اور اسنان کون سا نمبر ہے؟ یہ نمبر 2، تو ہم نے اسنان کے گرد دائرہ لگا دیا، ٹھیک ہے؟ اچھا جی، اب دوسرے باکس میں دیکھتے ہیں، یہاں پر کتنے سٹارز ہیں، سٹارز بنے ہوئے نا، तो ये देखते हैं कितने स्टार्स हैं, वाहिद, इस्नान, सलासा, ठीक है, वाहिद, इस्नान, सलासा, तो हम सलासा के गिर्द दायरा लगाएंगे यानी नंबर 3, ठीक है, कितने स्टार्स थे, सलासा, तो हमने सलासा के गिर्द दायरा लगाया। अच्छा, उसके बाद तीसरे बॉक्स में देखते हैं, वाहिद, इस्नान, सलासा, अरबा, खमसा, तो ये कितनी तस्वीर है, खमसा यानी 5, तो हमने खमसा के गिर दायरा लगाया, ठीक है, समझ आ गई ना सबको। अच्छा, अब उसके बाद हमने क्या करना है, खाली जगह पूर्ण करनी है, ठीक है, कुछ हरूफ तहजी लिखे हुए हैं और कुछ नहीं लिखे हुए, तो आपने देखना है कि इनके बाद कौन सी हरूफ तहजी आप लिखेंगे, ठीक है, तो सबसे पहले देखिए क्या है, मीम, क्या है, मीम, मीम के बाद क्या आता है, शाबाश, मीम के बाद आता है नून, क्या आता है, नून, और नून के बाद क्या लिखा हुआ है, हा, क्या लिखा हुआ है, हा, और हा के बाद क्या आता है, वेरी गुड, हा के बाद आता है वाओ, हा के बाद क्या आता है, वाओ, और वाओ के बाद, जी, वाओ के बाद क्या आता है, शाबाश, वाओ के बाद आता है या, क्या आता है, या, तो ये खाली जगह हमने पुट की, मीम, नून, हा, वाओ और या, ठीक है, सबको समझ आ गई ना, चलें ठीक है जी बच्चों, तो अब अगले काम की तरफ आ जाते हैं। अब हमने तस्वीर के पहले हर्फ पर दायरा लगाना है, ठीक है, 3 तस्वीर दी गई हैं और हर तस्वीर के नीचे 3 हरूफ तहजी भी हैं, तो हमने ये देखना है कि इस तस्वीर का जो नाम है वो कौन से हरूफ तहजी से शुरू हो रहा है, ठीक है, ये काम भी बच्चों आप पहले कर चुके हैं, यकीनन आपको याद होगा, ठीक है, याद है सबको, चलें दोबारा से इसकी रिविजन करते हैं तो इंशाल्लाह आपको याद आ जाएगा। तो सबसे पहली तस्वीर देखते हैं, ये क्या है, गिफ्ट है ना, इसको अरबी में क्या कहते हैं, हदिया, क्या कहते हैं, हदिया, और हदिया किससे शुरू होता है, हा से, किससे, हा से, तो हमने हा के गिर दायरा लगा दिया, ठीक है ना, हा था, नून था और मीम था, लेकिन हदिया हा से शुरू होता है तो हमने हा के गिर दायरा लगा दिया, ठीक है। अच्छा, अब दूसरी तस्वीर हाथी की है ना, तो हाथी को अरबी में क्या कहते हैं, शाबाश, सब बच्चों को पता है हाथी को अरबी में फील कहते हैं, क्या कहते हैं, फील, और फील किससे शुरू होता है, फा से, किससे शुरू होता है, फा से, तो हम फा के गिर दायरा लगाएंगे, ठीक है। अच्छा, आप तीसरी तस्वीर देखिए, ये क्या है, ये हिरन है, पढ़ा था ना हमने, और ये हिरन को अरबी में क्या कहते हैं, गजाल, ठीक है, गजाल कहते हैं, और अब ये बताइए कि गजाल किस हरूफ तहजी से शुरू होता है, गैन से, शाबाश, गैन से गजाल, क्या है, गैन से गजाल, तो हमने गैन के गिर दायरा लगाया, ठीक है। सबसे पहली तस्वीर थी हदिया की और हा से हदिया, फिर फा से फी, और फिर गैन से गजाल, ठीक है, अब याद रहेगा ना सब बच्चों को, वेरी गुड जी बच्चों, तो आज हमने पेज नंबर 25 पर काम किया है, अब आपने इसको अच्छे से याद करना है, ठीक है, क्योंकि आपके एग्जाम होने वाली है ना, ताकि आपकी अच्छे से तैयारी हो जाए, ठीक है, तो अपना बहुत सारा ख्याल रखिएगा, इंशाल्लाह अगले लेक्चर में फिर मुलाकात होगी, अल्लाह हाफिज़।